Hi Aries, I'm Anisha. You can also write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. You can also visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. And this is your monthly forecast for February 2013, the month of love. Aries, we start this month with a part of your chart that has to do with secrets. It has to do with behind the scenes activities. It has to do with karma. Yes, we're talking about your 8th house. Your 8th house is lit up in February. We have Mars. We also have the healing Chiron. We have Neptune. We also have the lovely Venus that is going to be transiting this part of your chart. Now, Venus is going to be coming and she's going to be adding her grace, her beauty, her love. And yes, she also rules money. So a lot of focus on the joint resources, shared resources with your partners, not just in the closest relationships, but also in your business relationships. I think this month is a lot of introspection that is going to be expected out of you. And a lot of you are going to be going deep within looking for answers. You are no longer Aries happy with the things the way that they have been so far. A lot of you will be seeking more. A lot of you will be wanting more in your closest relationships. Also, I think as far as your shared resources are concerned, especially if you are in a business partnership or even at work, you are going to be looking as to how it is that the arrangement has been faring so far. Is there some amount of tweaking that is required? Is there some amount of maybe redoing of a contract? Or how it is that the money that is it split? Is it the fair amount of money that is coming to you? Is it a fair amount of money that you're giving to the other partner? So a lot of focus is going to be there on this particular aspect. We also have Mars that is going to be trining with Saturn again in your 8th house. And Mars is your ruling planet, Aries. It brings with it a lot of energy, vitality. And yes, it also tends to bring about a lot of aggression with it. So be very careful, especially as far as your communication is concerned. Try not to be overtly aggressive. Assertive, yes, but be careful about the spoken speech or even written as far as documents are concerned, SMSs, emails. Be very careful over there. We also have, like I said, the healing Chiron that is there in this part of it. So a lot of healing can be expected from relationships, old wounds, old issues, things which you have been trying to either get over with, or it could be a bad relationship that you are just coming out of, or it could be a divorce, a settlement, something that left quite a bit of a bad taste in your mouth. The healing time is there now for you. Also, Saturn, since we know she's a planet of discipline and she's also the planet of accountability and responsibility. And like in my last video, I had explained that Saturn is very much a feminine energy, even though it has all the characteristics of a male planet, so to speak. Now, Saturn is going to be bringing about a lot of restraint for you. And especially, again, in these areas of your life, which are very 8th house areas. Again, how it is that the limitations that are there. Are you responsible? Are you accountable in your most intimate relationships? As far as the traditional astrology is concerned, 8th house was known as a house of taxes, sex and rebirth. It is a house of transformation. So use this energy well this month, Aries. From 18th onwards, we have a Mercury retrograde that happens, and Mercury will go retrograde for the next 3 weeks. And every time there's a Mercury retrograde, we all know the drill by now. Be very careful on your travel plans. Try not to initiate anything new. Try not to buy a big ticket or an expensive item at this point of time. And also try to be very, very careful about your communication at this point of time, Aries. Try to finish a lot of your important work in the first half of the month. So all the delays, all the frustrations, all the contemplation, introspection can happen towards the latter part of the year. Also, Mercury somewhere over here, Aries, is asking you to listen more this month. Try not to be the talkative one. Try not to cut the other person out. Yes, you have a point to make. You need to have yourself heard. And the time maybe is not right as soon as we start the year. So be careful over there. Give it some time. give your ear, listen to your partner, wait for your time, and then say as to what it is that you want to say. This month is also a month of compassion, Aries, for you. I think a lot of you need to let go, forgive things that have not worked for you. You need to not walk with grudges, and it's really a time of self-healing, Aries. It's very important that a lot of you realize that the past is done and over with. There is really no point in sort of tagging ahead or tagging along with a past mistake, with the past grudges. So let go of all the past mistakes that have happened, all the grudges that are there, and start afresh. Also, since Chiron is there, and also we have Neptune that is also going to be trining over there. And Neptune is a planet of inspiration. Neptune also tends to bring about some amount of fantasy and idealism with it. So be careful as to not to delude yourself, especially again where the closest relationships are concerned. Overall, looks like quite an exciting month for you, Aries. A lot of self-thinking, a lot of internalizing, a lot of going back within you. This month is really not, especially as far as after the 18th of February, it's not a month of action, Aries. It's really a month of contemplation. It's a month of re-looking at your plans. It's a month of revising, retweaking. The key this month for you, Aries, is to know things for what they really are. I think a lot of you are going to be seeking the truth, wanting to look at things, whether they are ugly or they're good or they're lovely, but in all honesty for what it is that they are. So that is the key message for you, truth at all cost this month. Overall, a great month for you, Aries. Have a lovely month. I'll see you again next month, and thank you so much for watching.